Hi, hello. Good morning, dear students. How are you all? This video lesson module number 4 on chemical reactions and equations brought to you by Vignan Global Gen Schools, Hyderabad. I, myself, Venkat Reddy Peyram, teaching faculty. My dear students, in the previous module, we have already learnt about combination reaction, types of combination reactions with various examples, decomposition reaction and different types of decomposition reactions. Okay, so hope everyone would understood all these two types of chemical reactions. Now today let us learn more information about displacement reactions and double displacement reactions. Okay, so displacement and double displacement reactions. So without delay, let me start the session. What do you say, my dear students? Yes, correct. So today let us learn more information about third type of reaction. What is that, my dear students? Displacement reactions. Displacement reactions. Now tell me, what is the actual meaning of displacement? Displace means taking the place of other element. Taking the place of other element. Taking the place of other element. Now, how to define a displacement reaction? Displace means replacing. So, an element is replaced by other element. For suppose, while playing the game, like cricket or kabaddi, if any player will get injury, that player is replaced by another fit player. That is also called replacement. Okay, so captain always doing like this in different games like this. Now here also, these are the chemical reactions which accompanied with replacing other elements. That means, how to define displacement reaction? Yes, displacement reaction. Those reactions in which, yes, a more reactive element is able to replace less reactive element from its compound or salt solution. So once again, reaction in which a more reactive element is able to replace less reactive element from its compound or salt solution to form new substances is called displacement reaction. Now, what is the general representation? How would we show displacement reaction? What is the general representation? Yes. Now, let us consider A is an element. One day it reacts with BC compound. So A is element, BC is a compound. Now here in BC, B is metal, A is also metal. Now A is more reactive than B. So here what is the condition, my dear students? A is more reactive than B. So A is able to replace the position of B, so that AC compound is formed, first product along with B element become set free. So this is the general representation of displacement reactions. Now let me take one example. One fine best example. What is that? Whenever if you drop iron nail in copper sulfate solution. What is the name of that solution? Copper sulfate aqueous solution. If you drop or dip an iron nail present in solid state in copper sulfate solution aqueous state. You know the color of copper sulfate, my dear students? The color of copper sulfate solution is blue. Yes. Then what would you observe? What is your observation? What do you observe? This iron is more reactive than copper. So automatically this iron is able to replace copper from copper sulfate solution. Because of that, after replacing, we will get iron sulfate. Still it is present in aqueous condition. Along with which element is set free, my dear students? Copper becomes set free. And before the reaction, what is the color of copper sulfate solution? Blue. After the reaction, this blue color slowly changes to pale green color. What is that color? Pale green color due to the formation of iron sulfate. And one more thing, on the iron nail, you are able to see copper metal as a deposit. Because you know copper is a shiny brown element, you can observe a brown deposit on iron nail. That indicates iron is able to replace copper. So this is about displacement reaction. Because a more reactive element is able to replace the position of less reactive element from its salt solution. So in order to describe this reaction, in our textbook, there is an activity. What is that activity number? Activity, my dear students, activity 1.9. You please refer this activity. What is that? 1.9. So in this activity, there are two test tubes named as A and B. Now, I am going to take iron nail in A test tube and keeping the test tube B left undisturbed like this. Then after 10 minutes, what is your observation? So the color of the solution in test tube A has changed because of the chemical reaction between iron nail and copper sulfate solution. Iron, being more reactive, is able to replace copper from copper sulfate solution. And after the reaction, if you compare that iron nail, what we dipped in copper sulfate with the original iron nail or fresh iron nail, there should be some difference. So fresh iron nail is a different color. And if you observe the reaction, iron nail is somewhat different. So this iron nail consisting of one layer, what is that layer called? Copper layer. So after the reaction, this copper formed as a layer on iron nail. So this is mainly because of displacement reaction, as iron is more reactive than copper. That's why iron is able to replace copper from copper sulfate solution. And color of the solution also changes from blue to pale green. And now let us discuss about one more similar example, my dear students. Let me take zinc in the place of iron. As usual, I am adding copper sulfate solution, which is present in aqueous condition. Zinc is present in solid condition. So this zinc is more reactive than copper. So zinc is able to replace copper from copper sulfate, so that you will get the zinc sulfate. It is still present in aqueous case. Along with which element is set free, my dear students? Copper, present in solid state. Before reaction, the color of copper sulfate solution is blue. Because of the displacement reaction, this blue color slowly fades out. You will get colorless solution. The solution becomes colorless due to the formation of zinc sulfate. This is also one of the best example for displacement reaction. In the same way, one more example let me take. Let us take lead, Pb, copper chloride gives rise to. So whenever you are adding lead metal to copper chloride aqueous solution, then automatically what happened, my dear students? Lead is more reactive than copper. So lead is able to replace copper from copper chloride solution. Then because of this displacement, we will get lead chloride PbCl2 along with the copper element to become set free. So before the reaction, solution color is blue, and later it becomes blue-green. The solution color is blue-green due to the formation of lead chloride. So these are the three important examples what you are going to study under this displacement reaction. So once again, my dear students, what are displacement reactions? So what is your response? Yes, you are correct. Those reactions in which a more reactive element is able to replace less reactive element from its compound or salt solution are called displacement reactions. And what is the general representation of displacement reaction? A plus BC gives rise to AC and B. So generally during this displacement reactions, there is a change in the color of the solution. Before one color, after the reaction, another color. And less reactive element is able to form as a layer on more reactive element, like deposition. So this is about displacement reactions. Now let us move on to the very next reaction. What is that, my dear students? Tell me, my dear. Double displacement reactions. Yes? Yes. Now I am going to explain about the very next type of chemical reaction, number 4. Double DOUBLE. Double displacement. Double displacement reactions. Double displacement reactions. So this is the fourth type of chemical reaction. So type of chemical reaction. Now before going to discuss about this reactions, so let us learn first of all what is the meaning of double. Double means two times. Do you know, my dear students, what is the meaning of double? Two times displacement takes place. So during these reactions, displacement takes place twice. That's why these reactions are called double displacement reactions. Now, what is the definition? What are double displacement reactions? Yes. Those reactions in which two substances in solution state mutually exchange their ions to form two new substances are called double displacement reactions. So, what are they? Two substances in solution state reacts with each other, by mutual exchange of ions, mutual exchange of ions to form two new substances are called double displacement reactions. Now, to understand these reactions in a very easy manner, there is a general representation. You try to understand this general representation. Let us consider AB is one substance. This is one substance AB. Now AB is present in which state? Aqueous state, solution state. Since previously it is present in solid state, after adding water you can prepare aqueous solution. AB aqueous solution. Now one more substance we will consider, that is CD, which is also present in aqueous solution, aqueous condition. After interaction, when AB interacts with CD, then AB is split up into two types of ions. Whenever you are adding water, AB is split up into A plus B minus ions. A plus is cation, B minus is anion. Like that, CD also split up into C plus cation, D minus anion. So in this mixture, there are four ions, two cations and two anions. And you know that A plus being positive, it is migrated towards D minus. C plus being positive migrated towards B minus. Because of these two types of displacement, see, this is single displacement, this is second displacement. There are two displacements. That's why this is called double displacement reaction. After the reaction, during this combination, the first product formed is AD and the second product formed is CB. There are two new substances are developed. See, AD, CB. Now, AD and CB are the new substances. Now, there are two types of double displacement reactions. How many types of double displacement reactions, Nana? Two types. What is the first one? Precipitation reaction. Precipitation reaction. So, precipitation reaction is one of the best example for double displacement reaction. Now, what is meant by precipitation reaction? Very simple. The reaction in which a precipitate is formed or a precipitate is obtained are called precipitation reactions. Now tell me, what is meant by precipitate? An insoluble product or an insoluble mass settled at the bottom of the test tube is called precipitate. So here, precipitate is an insoluble product that can be separated out from the mixture by using filtration technique. Precipitate, because of heavy mass, settled at the bottom of the test tube. And it is insoluble matter, insoluble solid matter. Okay. And what is the short form of the precipitate? Simply we can write as PPT. And the arrow used in order to indicate precipitate is a downward arrow mark that we have already learnt. Now let me take one example. So for this example, one activity is there in our textbook. What is that activity, my dear students? Activity 1.10. Activity 1.10. What is that activity, my dear students? Activity 1.10. Now in this activity, let me take two test tubes. Yes, there are two test tubes like this. Okay, na? There are two test tubes. In first test tube, there is an aqueous solution. We are taking some aqueous solution. What is the name of that aqueous solution? Barium chloride aqueous solution. In the second test tube, one more aqueous solution we already prepared. What is the name of that aqueous solution? Sodium sulfate. Na2SO4. Sodium sulfate. So, in the first test tube, what is the name of the aqueous solution prepared? Barium chloride aqueous solution is present. And in the second test tube, sodium sulfate aqueous solution is prepared. Now, both the solutions are colorless. Both these aqueous solutions are colorless. Now, whenever you are adding, like this, you can take. Whenever, these are the two test tubes. Whenever you are adding barium chloride solution to sodium sulfate drop by drop, immediately, within nth second, there is a precipitate formed. We are able to observe a white precipitate. we are able to observe a white precipitate. And this white precipitate is due to the formation of barium sulfate. So barium sulfate material, which is insoluble in the solution, settled at the bottom of the test tube, and that's why we are using downward arrow. So name the substance precipitated. Yes, you are correct. Barium sulfate. What is the color? White color. Now let me describe this chemical reaction here. So barium chloride formula BaCl2, which is present in aqueous state. Sodium sulfate Na2SO4, which is present in aqueous state. Both are mixing with each other. They mutually exchange their ions, where double displacement takes place. Now Ba ions are migrated towards sulfate, that's why BaSO4 precipitate is obtained, which is white in color. Along with one more aqueous solution is obtained, that is sodium chloride. Sodium chloride is present in aqueous state, barium sulfate is present in solid state. So to balance this chemical equation, let us take here 2 as coefficient. So 1 Ba, 1 Ba balanced, 2 Cl, 2 Cl balanced, 2 Na, SO4 balanced. So this is about a precipitation reaction, because these reactions are proceeded with the formation of precipitate. Okay. Now coming to second type of double displacement reactions. What is that? Neutralization reaction. Neutralization reaction. So what is the second type of displacement reaction, my dear students? Double displacement, neutralization. You know what is meant by neutralization? Those reactions in which an acid reacts with a base NaOH to form salt NaCl and water is called neutralization reaction. Since both this acid and base nullified each other's effect, this is called neutralization reaction. So once again, my dear students, what are neutralization reactions? Reaction in which an acid reacts with a base to form salt and water. So this is called neutralization reaction. Now one more example for double displacement reaction, that is in the form of precipitation. From activity number 1.2, what we already discussed in the first module, where lead nitrate aqueous solution mixed with potassium iodide aqueous solution, then you will get an yellow precipitate of lead iodide along with potassium nitrate aqueous solution. Okay, so that is also comes under double displacement reactions. These double displacement reactions are also called double decomposition reactions, because decomposition occur twice. So first molecule undergo decomposition like this, and second substance also undergo decomposition. So the other name of double displacement is a double decomposition reaction. So this is about today's module, about only 2 chemical reactions which are very important for examination point of view. What are they, my dear students? Displacement reactions and double displacement reactions. In the very next module, we shall discuss about last type of reaction number 5, where oxidation and reduction occur simultaneously. And these reactions are collectively called redox reactions. So before going to discuss about that, so let me conclude this today's module. Hope everyone would understood this particular reactions like displacement and double displacement reactions. You try to work out definition, general formula, general representation, various examples and various activities. Till then, my dear students, have a nice day. Thank you.